No fun intro today. We've got a couple of announcements and some things to go over, so I want to get right to the point. So stay tuned.
Nerdy dude stuff.
What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another video about Bitcoin, cryptocurrency, helium mining, really just helium mining, and all that good stuff. If this is your first time on the channel, please take a moment to consider hitting that subscribe button and turning on the bell notification as we post videos weekly. Don't forget to like the video, leave a comment, blah, 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 blah. Now, the reason why I say turn the bell notification on is because this is going to be our last video for this week. We are actually going out of town tomorrow until Sunday. We are going to be going up north to visit some friends, but we do have a plan to bring you some content. So, speaking of that plan, for those of you keeping track at home, prepare to be really pissed off, because today we're drinking
a White Claw.
This is the blackberry flavor. I didn't really want to stock my fridge with any beer or anything like that before going on vacation. Cheers to you guys. The reason why I say that over the next week is we are going to be going up north and we're going to be visiting many a brewery, and we will probably give some YouTube shorts on the beers that we're trying at these little micro brews. So we're very excited about that. If you guys want to watch it, great. There'll be like 1 to 2 minute beer reviews, or maybe a little bit longer based on the brewery that we go to. If you don't want to watch it, I completely understand. If you're here for cryptocurrency and you're not here for beer reviews, then I have no problem with that. But just check it out just in case that we do. Another announcement slash idea that I'm looking at trying is a few commenters have stated that they are in the general vicinity of my location, which is awesome. I can't believe I'm almost to 10,000 subscribers. It's so cool to have you guys so close. I am thinking about collaborating with a local bar, not really like a collaboration, but just getting permission to host a local meetup. If you are in the area, and we haven't set the date or anything like that, but if you're in the area and there's like 5, 6, 7, or 8 subscribers or commenters that want to get together, have a couple of beers, talk about cryptocurrency, let me know in the comments below and I can start looking at organizing something. Ultimately, I would love to get to a point where I'm large enough to where I could do a big meetup event at a bar and have like 40, 50, 60 people there, and we can do a live show while drinking beers. So let me know if that's something you'd be interested in. You guys know where I'm located, in the general vicinity around Disney World in Florida, if you want to get together just to have a couple of beers and talk crypto face to face. Leave that in the comment below. Now, we have been helium mining for over a month now. We've had some ups and downs. You guys know that we have been doing trial and error with antennas. We've had the crappy antennas, we've had the great antennas. We'll show the antennas that we finally settled on here in a moment. We've been working on placement, from putting antennas by windows, which we learned that you should not be doing because the double paned windows will refract the signal and not let that out. A commenter said, if you absolutely need to leave it in your house, make sure you put it in somewhere in the middle of the house and up high, and that should be for the best. We've had everything from crappy antennas up in our attic. Now, finally, we have a scenario where we do have an antenna externally outside of a house and an antenna on the inside. And now, with it being the 17th, we are just over a week of having, are we over a week? No, now we're over 2 weeks of having that antenna outside and getting the results that we want. So we're going to take a look at that here and look at the difference between internally and externally, because we have both that set up. Spoiler alert, I do believe at the end of this month I will be getting either a 30-foot flagpole and putting my antenna on top of that on the outside of my house, or going up through the attic. It really is based on going up through the attic and then mounting it to the outside of my house through the wall. It's really based on where I can put the placement of the miner in the best temperature controlled setting. So let's look at the two miners and the differences between the external and the internal setup, shall we? Here are our two miners. We have Sour Walnut Goat and Brief Taupe Fox. We have miner number one and miner number two. Miner number one right here has the internal antenna up in the attic. Miner number two has the external antenna outside of my in-law's house. Those two antennas are the 5.8 dBi antenna from Rack. You can get yours and save 5% by clicking on the link in the description of this video. They're $40 a piece. There is a $10. Shut up, copper! There is a $10 add-on for a magnetic base, which we did not add that, and I don't recommend that unless you're not able to mount this antenna anywhere and you need to put it in the middle of your house. And shipping is a little pricey, so if you want to get two, I can justify the cost of the shipping. One, maybe, you know, the returns will be good. just enough to justify it. So again, 5% off, link in the description if you guys want the same exact antennas. Going back to our miner, we have this one here and this one here. This gentleman popped up last week, which we're very excited because we are also now in communication with them via our hotspots. They are bouncing off of each other, but we are here to talk about the difference between the two antennas. Looking at our internal antenna, this is just a 24-hour result. We are at a 0.08 HNT return. And then currently with our external antenna, we're at a 0.16 HNT return. Let's go to a grand overview of both accounts together. We are currently sitting at 9 helium at just under $200 value. So we are about $1,000 to $1,100 before breaking even. And so we're very excited about that. Very good steps. And you can see here in the past 30-day chart, when we first got our antennas, we didn't really have a lot of activity going. I'm sorry, words are hard. We didn't have a lot going up until the crucial moment when we mounted that antenna outdoors. We had a week of just having our 5.8 antenna internally. So that was the week right here where we had about 0.23, 0.35, 0.39, 0.48, 0.51. So just over half an HNT just on that internal antenna while we were still losing to the 4.0 dBi antenna that was next to a window. And then when we installed that external antenna, we have seen this nice spike all the way up to our biggest day was just shy of 1 HNT. So you can see that change in the chart right here on how much that grew already with a couple of lulls. But even the lulls are 0.19, 0.29, 0.22, 0.30, and then back up to 0.57. We really want to get ourselves in a position where we're making over half a helium a day, which would be ideal. Currently sitting on a weekly return of 2.1 helium, and at the current price of helium, that's $47. I know that the numbers were better back in the day, but I am very excited to be pulling in at least $50 a week with these antennas, and this is inspiring me to move my other antenna outdoors. Let's take a look at the activity of each one individually. So this antenna in the past 24 hours has pulled 0.05, just said 0.08 because that hour just shifted out. Yes, it did. The hour just shifted out from when I last looked. And you can see we just got a payout about an hour ago of 0.03. The last 7 days, this bad boy has pulled in 0.41 HNT. So let's take a look at this miner down here on the last 7 days just to see a difference in the comparison. So we're looking at 0.41 from our one miner right here with the internal, again, 0.41 with the internal antenna versus a 7 day return with the external antenna of 1.724 HNT. That just speaks alone right there. Does this have any witnesses at the moment? Nothing nearby, nothing really, nothing today. Although we did just get a transaction within the past hour for 0.15. And I'm sure, let's look at all the activity. I'm sure this is something that probably witnessed each other or was witnessed. I think doing the witnessing is what is giving the HNT reward payout. God, this is slow. Okay, so it's gotta switch over. You can see the rewards here too. We've gotten, there it goes. I'll show the rewards here in just a moment. Yeah, so it witnessed a beacon. Let's see if we can see. So cool. This is exactly what we wanted, was our two to be talking back and forth to each other. So it did witness a beacon sent out by my brief Taupe Fox. And what's happening is, what I'm noticing is that this is our beaconer. This has been consistently our beaconer, and this has been consistently our witness. And this is the goal of having these two together. Now what we need to do is we need to flip it and reverse it and have this one also be a witness while this one's being a beaconer, because this one, I believe, is sending out beacons and is not getting any witnesses. And you can see that right here. Sent a beacon today, sent a beacon this morning, sent a beacon this morning, no witnesses. Challenged a beaconer, created a challenge, created a challenge, created a challenge. Receive mining rewards. Where's another witness one? Yeah, I think the past 2 days have been relatively so. All right, witness to beacon right here. And again, that actually came from Keen Daffodil Bird. So the person that put their antenna up, or their hotspot miner up right here, my two are witnessing as well, which I'm very happy about that. But I think the reason why this one is successfully, my top one is successfully witnessing this one, is because they are so close together. And this one isn't, this one, to witness the beacon, isn't being too heavily hindered by this one, or by the being inside my attic. So it's got enough power or juice to be able to witness this one's beacon. So we can go here and we can see that my two are in communication with this one. Let's look at this one's activity. And he still has relayed, so we can work on getting you out of that if you need as well. Let's take a look at your activity. God, this is slow. And then we're going to look at mine. You are getting mining rewards. Yep. Oh, cool. Looks like you got a witness. Let's see what that one was. Let's see if we can get it over here in all activity. So you did witness. You got 0.13, which is awesome. 0.11. So it looks like you're getting some witnessing. There we go. All right. So this is another thing I'm noticing, too, when, with Keen Daffodil, is that we are getting some invalid witnesses. So I think that's why some of this stuff is low. Witness RSSI below lower bound. So that's something that you've got to look into, that we've got to look into. Here's another one. Witnessed a beacon that was invalid. And that looks like it was witnessing a beacon from me as well. And then the one right here. What was this one? Oh, you witnessed my beacon from this as well. It's interesting that this sent a beacon and wasn't witnessed by mine down there. So let's jump back up to this one and take a look at this as full activity. In the past 30 days, it's gotten 2.78 HNT, where I think the other one's up to like 4 HNT, which is solid. And let's go to the activity here just to take a look at what the rewards are as well, because this one's been much, much lower. Just because I believe it's only beaconing and having challenges and beaconing, and it's not really witnessing the other ones as much as it should. And I do wholeheartedly now believe that is, you can see there's no monstrous witnessing. And I do wholeheartedly believe that's not necessarily because of the antenna. I believe it's because the antenna is inside the attic. So we will be positioning that externally at the end of the month. Here we go. So it is sending beacons, and you can see the beacon was right there. Did challenge a beaconer, sent a beacon, which was zero, created a challenge, sent a beacon, got a witness. So it's gotten some activity, which is excellent. Sent a beacon, got a witness, transfer packets, mining rewards, challenge a beacon, create a challenge, sent a beacon, getting witness. So its beacons are getting witness. And then back a day ago, it did witness a beacon, but that one popped out as invalid as well. So I wonder what's going on with that. But you can see here that it is sending beacons and it is getting witnessed, but it's not witnessing as much as I would like it to down. Nyah. So let's go back to the statistics just so I can pull up the 30-day charts on each one. So this one in the past 30 days is 2.78, so just shy of 3. And then this one in the past 30 days has had a 4.07, so almost double its productivity just in the past 30 days. Just in the past 2 weeks, I guarantee it doubled that productivity. Let's go to the chart, 30 days. Because of positioning, you could see, yeah, once we position that antenna externally, the activity just increased. So very, very happy with the result of positioning it externally. I'm actually okay with sitting out in the hot sun to do that. This one, I had a top day of half an HNT. So if I can get both of my guys getting top days of one half an HNT each, we are going to be happy and in the moolah. So yeah, I like what I see. You guys have any questions, comments, concerns? If you guys know about the invalid witnessing, please leave a comment about that below so we can work on improving that and maybe we can have even more rewards. I do feel that if those witnesses weren't as invalid, this miner would have had some significant increase in HNT for the 30-day chart as well. So any help or assistance there would be absolutely appreciated and totally awesome of you. Other than that, reach out to me on Telegram, Twitter, Discord. If you guys want to think about doing that meetup event and trying, you know, having some beers and talking and hanging out, and you know, potentially one day we could be a big YouTuber and do a whole production and show in front of everyone, do a whole live show while we've got a live chat on a screen while we're doing my computer screen, while we're, you know, engaging with the audience, that would be awesome. Other than that, like, comment, subscribe, turn on post notification, all that good stuff. I'm Oprius, and we'll see you guys next time.